Hey, what's up? It's Jim, and today I'm going to talk about Tales from the Far Side from 1994. Gary Larson's The Far Side was one of the biggest newspaper comics of the 80s and 90s, and was literally everywhere, from like t-shirts to posters to wall calendars to bumper stickers to references and like pretty much every show you can imagine to wall calendars. Far Side was literally everywhere, and much like any popular comic strip from that era, including like Garfield, the Peanuts before it, and that Calvin and Hobbes special that doesn't exist, The Far Side got its own special, and that's what I'm talking about today with Tales from the Far Side. Now, if you haven't heard of this special, that's most likely because it only aired once in America, and that was on October 26th, 1994. It was on CBS and it was actually highly promoted, and you kind of think, given how hugely popular The Far Side was in the 90s, that they'd probably re-air this again. They didn't. I watched it and taped it, actually. I was a big fan of newspaper comics or comic strips, or this wasn't really a comic strip because it's like one panel, thus why I'm saying newspaper comics, because it doesn't feel like a strip. But I was really into those. I mean, I had a really good era of those to grow up in. It might have been the last great era. I guess Boondocks happened after, but other than that, you know, we got Calvin and Hobbes, The Far Side, Garfield was decent. Berkeley Breathitt was still making stuff. There was still, you know, Mother Goose and Grimm. There was still some cool stuff going on the comics page, and some really cool, really widely imaginative stuff. Now, The Far Side normally is just one square. It's like one panel. It's nothing more than that. The Sunday strips would have more than that, but usually it was just one single image of Gary Larson's The Far Side. And in addition to anything else I've mentioned that had a comic special like Kathy or something, all those comic strips have sort of a main character that you would follow, thus what usually the comic strip's named after. Gary Larson's The Far Side didn't. You know, you knew he liked cows, you knew the kind of iconography he liked, you knew the kind of humor, but other than that, there wasn't really a main selling point kind of caricature that you could, you know, have sell MetLife or something. So the idea of making a special of The Far Side kind of feels like sort of a weird idea, and the result is completely sort of bizarre, even for a Halloween horror special. Now, Tales from the Far Side, I think, starts off like, you know, you get this thing of like, you know, a cow. The 90s was really into cows, between Gateway Computers and The Far Side. I don't know what made cows so funny to people, but I guess, you know, people in the 90s did eat more hamburgers, maybe. Don't quote me on that, but probably. But anyway, they make a Bride of Frankenstein, you know, cow that feels sort of like a Far Side thing. Sheep are, you know, revolting and stuff, and that feels sort of normal. And they have a crazy good pan that feels right out of the Far Side comics, like almost perfectly. But then when you get to the other parts of this, it sort of loses its kind of regular Far Side humor, and there's also not really any laugh out loud moments. It's sort of just selling its 90s Far Side quirkiness as much as humanly possible. But it's not really as funny necessarily. I think there are some funny parts later on in the special, but I do think it's kind of got this weird melancholy vibe to it that it never really escapes. I sort of like that this was a highly, you know, promoted special. I knew about it and I wasn't like the most pop culture literate person in 1994, but it was definitely something I knew about and like really wanted to watch and to like sit there and tape it and stuff. You kind of think of Far Side, when you really think about it, that's not something that would probably work in a longer animated format. It's not really made to do that. You can't really have a narrative based on The Far Side. It's not really something that goes towards, you know, longer narrative. It works in just a simple shot, which is definitely still storytelling. I'm not going to rob it. I think it's actually a really funny comic strip, but it just doesn't work as an animated thing. And I think in some places this does work, but in other places it shows how this was like not really mainstream enough to go beyond the era in which it was like literally the most mainstream thing imaginable. There are certain parts of this, like there's a part with these hunters, they run into a deer, they shoot the deer, and they're driving along, and there's all sorts of funny Far Side-esque kind of jokes in it, and then, you know, some aliens shoot these hunters. It's kind of like a funny kind of circle of life type of thing that I think The Far Side's really good at. And that kind of shows where I think this definitely could really work. But then there's other sides of this that is just like, I don't know what you're doing. This is a weird moment I'm in. A little kid in elementary school, and now I'm really sad now, which was what was going on with this. Because they have this one part in particular that is such a tonal down with this wolf watching home movies and drinking whiskey. And you slowly realize that this wolf is watching home movies of their lover who was captured and then killed. And they're drinking whiskey, presumably late at night, watching this film reel of the last of their lover while, you know, it kind of just drinks itself in oblivion and looks sad. And I don't know why CBS let that on. They did cut one of the cartoons, which was then put on the VHS or DVD that you could buy from the Fireside website. You can't anymore, or at least I couldn't find it, along with a sequel, which I didn't know about, which didn't air in America and only aired in England and a few other places, and then you could get it on this VHS DVD thing, but it's not available online, or at least when I made this review. I do think there are certain things about this that sort of work. They have this exploding kid gag with a monster. They have, you know, certain ones, but then they have things that's like, it's definitely like the Far Side. It's like the Far Side sense of humor, but it's not really as funny when you're, you know, actually hearing the horrific elements. Like you see a carrot get ripped out and, like, you know, be eaten by a bunny, and you see, like, how the horrific elements of, like, a carrot's perspective. That's not, it's like a kind of odd meta humor kind of thing. But then you have this thing where these two eggs are, like, making out in a car, and then, you know, this woman comes with an egg beater and, like, attacks them, like it's a slasher movie. That was actually kind of funny, as well as horrific. And there are not a lot of moments in this where it, like, balances that as well as, like, you know, a Treehouse of Horrorwood or something like that. It seems like it was having a lot of difficulty getting, like, the humor of the Far Side and getting, like, those kind of laughs and humor that kind of transcend that, really. This was actually directed by Marv Newland, who's probably most famous for one of the most Far Side-like comic cartoon shorts I can think of, which was Bambi vs. Godzilla. And I definitely think, you know, if they're having a meeting on who should direct this and the Bambi vs. Godzilla guy walked in, I would agree he should definitely be the guy who directs the Far Side special. That seems almost like too perfect in a way. It's not necessarily, I think, Marv Newland. I mean, this actually was pretty well regarded. It won the Grand Prix at the Annecy Animation Festival. It was definitely sort of like a different thing, and it is really different from a highly promoted comic strip special, and I'm a little surprised they waited so long to make something like this. But it kind of goes into one of the things about the 90s that, you know, I liked the natural strange and weirdness as, you know, a true 90s kid. I loved all, you know, the sonic youthiness of, you know, that you let these weird art school kids, you know, take over alternative and all that stuff. But at a certain point, like, I don't think normal people like that. They only like bits of it. And I think in bits, this special works. I would say that the special Tales from the Far Side is really interesting. It's interesting that Gary Larson could get away with it, but it kind of shows you the limitations of the Far Side. I will say it's interesting seeing someone take the Far Side, but it kind of shows you the real differences between sometimes something works in one medium and it doesn't mean it's going to work in another. And I know a lot of times, naturally, because of the multimedia world we live in, things are kind of expected to work in every medium. And, you know, certainly Far Side worked for, like, wall calendars and stuff. But, like, or, you know, those calendars where you can rip off, I don't know what they're called, where you rip off a day-to-day calendars or whatever. They're very good at that. But it doesn't work for animated specials because it's just sort of like a series of weird shorts. And tonally, you can bounce around from comic strip to comic strip. But the humor, just like the display of the humor of Gary Larson, maybe wasn't enough. The last short of this whole thing, where it's just this guy who gets scared and he's running around the forest screaming, is, like, not funny. Now, the one thing that should be pointed out is the original short that aired on CBS is different from the one that's widely available, which is clearly a rip from the VHS. I wish someone would rip the CBS edit, because the end joke to that one, because I found at least that part, is actually really funny, whereas the one they put up is, like, not nearly as funny. So they, like, actually the director's cut sucks more, which is usually the case. And they actually add an extra cartoon in there, which is, like, way less funny, about, like, you know, these, like, I guess tribal headhunter voodoo people who find, you know, who cut off people's heads and find someone with a really big head. And it's just, like, not really funny. It brings down the whole special, to be honest with you. I totally understand why that was cut completely from it. But I also understand, like, why this wasn't aired again, because it kind of just, I remember as a kid, it put me in a weird mood and it, like, felt a little off, especially that wolf thing. I always remembered that. And I especially was like, I think when I was older, I was like, this isn't funny. Like, this is just sad. Like, what? It's like an interesting down moment, but like, I don't entirely know what it's saying. And I think there's, you know, sort of funny semi parts. Like, there's a bunch of bugs on a bug plane watching the fly and like really liking the part where he turns into a fly. That's kind of funny. And it's like the zombie dude ranch and like aliens would try to pretend to be cowboys part. And there's certain things that are funny. I will say the director's cut doesn't work as well, so I wish they just released the one that aired in America. But it's sort of an odd humor of a special, and not just like odd in the fun way that Far Side was. It's just odd in like having these sort of weird tonal shifts and stuff, and like it really doesn't feel like reading a Far Side book, because I pulled out one of those I have, and I was really, which I should have had behind me in this video, but whatever, that I felt was a lot funnier going through that. Like, it didn't feel like I was reading the Far Side. It felt like this whole different thing. There are theories online that this was because Gary Larson ended the Far Side a little bit after this aired. He ended the Far Side on January 1st, 1995. The idea of this, or the potential of this, is this was a TV pilot and that they would have made, you know, a Far Side cartoon series, and he was preparing to work on that, and that didn't work out, and he just ended the Far Side. I have found, like, literally nothing to show the validity of that. There's no, like, Gary Larson interview where he's like, well, I gave it all up for this cartoon show that never happened. I don't think that was the case. I understand, like, the thinking behind that, to be honest. Like, I when people brought up, I'm like, oh, I can sort of understand why people thought that. But, like, I remember reading everything that happened when this was promoted, and I don't remember anything from that. If you like The Far Side, or you're, like, obsessed about The Far Side, or the idea of an animated Far Side really speaks to you, then I think you should see this, because it's probably, like, it's a fun enough of a watch for a half hour, because you'd be like, that was strange and not really as satisfying as reading The Far Side. But I think what really fails about this is when you think of the great animated specials from comic strips, whether it's Garfield or the Peanut, or mainly those two, but all the ones that there are, people would watch those and not read the comic strips. Like, they, like, there's a lot of people who've experienced Garfield or Peanuts just in those animated specials and barely read the comic strips. And the Far Side thing, I don't think worked in that way at all. Like, you definitely saw that this wouldn't work. This was too weird. I think if they made, like, little shorts of the Far Side, much like the Simpsons shorts around, like, a SNL or something like that, or just had them be like, oh, you know, between shows on CBS you get little Far Side cartoons, that could have worked. Because, like, they have one part where it's like, meanwhile in Egypt, and all these guys turn and say hey, like, that's kind of funny. But the overallness of this is just, it always puts me in a weird mood, and I'm just like, I don't, what? And, like, I can't imagine the network. I'm sure they heavily promoted because they knew people would watch it once, but you can't really, it's like, no one has, I don't remember anyone having necessarily, like, pleasant memories. It's just sort of like this odd, strange little special. And I appreciate that they did something that, like, clearly they were doing things that they thought were cool, but overall it's like you're not learning any storytelling lessons from this, other than maybe, like, not how to make an animated special necessarily. I would love actually to see part two, which I've never seen and can't find anywhere, and I've looked a couple times. It's never on any sites I can find, or through Google or anything, so I hope they make that available. Actually, I can see why, you know, that came out in 97, 3 years later, and not available in America, so clearly this was a huge hit. While I was watching it, I think there are certain ones that actually get the right humor, and I think if they had the right, maybe a different script or a better special, I'm curious if the second one works better. I think it would take a lot of figuring out. Maybe if it was a show, like, I think they could have figured out and gotten a good rhythm to it. There definitely shows potential. But doing an anthology show that you're really just coming for the kind of type of humor is a weird sell. It sort of works for The Far Side in the comic strip. I don't know if, like, you know, Gary Larson as a person is enough to sell a whole show, and I don't think his humor can transcend that. And this is kind of like an interesting, odd little, like, relic of a time. But having rewatched it for the first time in like 25-6 years or something like that, I mean, maybe I'd watch it since then, but I don't think I watched it much past 1994, probably a couple times since then. I mean, this was definitely a gem of my, you know, things I taped off TV VHS collection in the 90s. But other than that, this isn't like something I'll probably ever revisit in my life again. I mainly, because I was like, wow, I should revisit this, see what it was really like, because there really aren't enough reviews of this, because it is such an odd kind of example of, you know, how popular was The Far Side that they could get away with this. I like The Far Side. It was fun going into this and remembering how popular and how great that comic strip was, but I think this was just, they kind of ended up with like a weird special that gets really close to capturing the essence of the comedy of The Far Side. But I think like most anthology things, or like most anthology comedy things, or even SNL itself, certainly some of these could be cut out and made into, you know, memes now or TikToks or anything like that, and people would probably love them. But the overall feel of the special just puts you in a like weird mood where it didn't necessarily make me want to see more cartoons. It did make me want to read more Far Side, but it didn't really want me to see another cartoon of this. So I don't know if this special entirely worked, unless it was to, you know, have me read a comic strip that would be canceled in 2 months. So if you have seen Tales from the Far Side and you would like to talk about it, then comment below in the comments and subscribe if you would like to.